Hey everybody, welcome to the trailer. I'm Yasser Lester.
And I'm Aaron Gibson. And Yasser, this may be the biggest episode of the trailer yet.
Aaron, I kind of feel like it is.
It is, it absolutely is. Regal announced that they have the exclusive Amazing Spider-Man 2 Super Ticket.
Exactly, and I feel like I need to break down what that is, okay? Yep. For the Super Ticket, it's $20. You get an HD digital download of The Amazing Spider-Man 1, the one that came out in 2012, mm-hmm. and you get an HD digital download of The Amazing Spider-Man 2 before it hits DVD and Blu-ray.
That's right, you can watch the movie a million times before anyone can even buy it.
Yeah, like a million gazillion times.
A million gazillion.
If you wanted to, if you were persistent.
Yeah, if you have commitment.
Right.
It also makes it cheaper.
Yeah, it's like half the price that it would be at Best Buy or on iTunes.
That's right. And I'm excited about this Amazing Spider-Man because all the villains are back. Harry Osborn, Electro, Rhino, all the supervillain group.
Okay, well, we've gone through this, mm-hmm. and they are called the Rogues Gallery.
Got it.
Just for next time, let's use that term. And to honor Electro and Rhino hitting the big screen, I am going to test your Spider-Man villains Rogues Gallery knowledge.
Challenge accepted.
Okay, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to list off some villains, and you're going to tell me whether they are real or if I made them up.
Okay, I can do this. I'm smart. I'm a smart person. I am.
We about to find out,
okay.
aren't we? Okay. The first one is Mr. Negative. He is a man who runs a soup kitchen to feed the homeless. Mr. Negative, he feeds the homeless.
I'm going to guess he's real because it's too complicated to... I don't think you could have... No offense, I don't think you could have made that up. It's just got too many weird factors in it.
Okay, well, guess what? Ding, 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 ding. You are right. Yes, and he looks like a film negative.
Mr. Negative.
They really, they're like, let's just make him backwards in colors, essentially. Okay.
Yeah.
The next one is the Tarantula. He is the communist version of Captain America.
Real? I almost said fake, but I changed it to real last minute because I feel like tarantulas and spiders would naturally hate each other because, you know, they're like solo. They do solo.
Well, I mean,
their
tarantulas and spiders are
kind of the same thing, but in general, spiders are like solo artists. They're like, you know, whatever. Mick Jagger without the Stones.
Okay.
I could have found a different. So Sting. All spiders are like Sting.
You know what? You just went a really long way for me to tell you that you're right.
Thank you.
You're right. You don't have to worry about it anymore.
I'm okay? So nervous.
All right. The next one is the Narwhal. He's a Hudson River pirate who dresses like a narwhal.
Fake? But I want him to be real.
Okay, he is in fact fake. I made him up and submitted the idea to Marvel and won't return my calls, but we're fine.
You okay?
Just really excited about him and I just think it's really clever and smart and it would really work well in their universe.
You seem not okay right now.
I'm okay. I am. Okay, let's just move on to the last one, huh?
Okay.
All right. The Lizard. He's a bad guy who can regrow his limbs.
Come on, did you think I didn't see The Amazing Spider-Man? Of course I did. He was the villain in The Amazing Spider-Man. I mean, yeah, I haven't seen the movie since it was in theaters, but that's why I'm getting the super ticket.
Yeah, we got some other reptiles hitting the big screen. We're gonna see what makes Megan Fox faint.
And bear safety tips that you cannot miss.
And what's the world's most terrifying cartoon? We're gonna find out.
But first, you know, a lot of cartoons are making the leap into live action, including Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Aaron, this is why I woke up today.
That's right. Cowabunga, dudes. The trailer's out.
And cowabunga, dudettes. Let's take a look.
Crime, violence, and fear have run rampant. Our great city is being destroyed. People want justice restored to this world. People want heroes, Ms. O'Neill. But heroes are not born. They're created. That's what your father and I were trying to do. Create heroes.
Johnny! Whoa, chills. Just a mask. See? Don't freak out. Right?
I am shocked.
You're shell-shocked.
This is serious, because I am legitimately scared.
Okay, is it the lips thing?
Yes, the lips are terrifying. They're real lips. They're not like before when they were like Muppet Mouse.
Yeah, but that's cool though. They're like these mutant human hybrids now. They look amazing.
They do look amazing. They do look terrifying. Also, but they're gonna be, what I like about it is I know they're gonna be terrifying and they're gonna be like, what's up, dude?
Yeah,
they're gonna have those California voices.
Yeah, and they're just gonna be like, they look like real ninjas. They're doing ninja things. They're using their shells as like battering rams. Like, that's cool. Finally.
I feel like they've been doing like prison yard workouts because they look so ripped.
Supplements.
Oh, creatine and all that. Yeah. Well, I mean, they can't look like that just eating pizza and ooze.
They're teenagers. Of course they can.
Right.
Don't you remember high school where it was just guys that were just like super ripped and like, oh, sorry, I was just at Taco Bell for 19 hours straight. And you're like, what? How?
Eating gorditas all day.
Oh, that sounds so good.
Those were the days. I am a little bummed, I have to say. This movie looks so rad, but I know there's not going to be any like turtle breakdancing because it's not that kind of movie. And tiny inside young me is kind of weeps for that.
Okay, here's the thing. I think you may be pleasantly surprised.
You think there's going to be a breakdancing scene in this movie?
If you can smash a turtle into a Hummer, why can't they dance?
Yeah, they've got to let loose somehow.
Yeah, absolutely.
Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. They want to cut a rug, but okay, honestly, I feel like we're skipping over something very important to me. The shot of William Fichtner.
Oh, yeah.
Like, staring at Shredder? Come on!
He is Shredder.
It's a mystery!
No, no!
Because is he talking to a guy in the costume right now? Is it just the costume hanging up? We don't know.
No one knows.
But Fichtner's going to be like...
Fichtner knows.
Yeah, Fichtner knows.
I hope he's just like the new like villain. Like, anytime someone needs a villain, they're just like, Fichtner, are you available?
Yeah, Gary Oldman. Fichtner's taking it. Sorry.
Yeah, that's
Chris Jenner. Sorry. Fichtner's got the role.
All the big villains.
All the huge villains.
All the big villains. He's going to be on a mountain. Fichtner's going to be on a mountain with all the other villains.
Yes, it's going to be...
In the Rogue Gallery Rushmore. Did I do that?
Rogues.
Gallery.
Okay. But it was still pretty
good. That was
close. Yeah.
We're going to have to find out all the answers in August, which is not the soonest. Boo. Yeah. Right. But you know what animal movie is coming out this weekend that I'm really excited for? Disney Nature's Bears. It is a beautiful documentary about this family of bears in Alaska, and it comes out on April 18th, which is Earth Day.
Bears are terrifying.
I know this about you, and that's why we sent you to speak to a bears expert.
Yeah, you did.
Let's take a look.
Hey, everybody. Disney's Bears is hitting Regal Theaters this week, and to celebrate, we brought in our own animal expert, Rich Fulcher. How you doing, man?
Thanks, Yasser. I'm very excited to be here.
Okay, well, you're going to share with us some pretty cool bear facts, right? Mm.
Well, I did take a ukulele lesson last night, but I got a chance to Google a lot afterwards, so yes, I think I am ready.
Well, let's say if we encounter a bear, what's the
when
first thing?
When we encounter a bear.
Okay.
It's going to happen to all of us.
Okay. When we encounter a bear, what's the first thing we want to do?
First thing we want to do, don't run.
Don't run? I'm known as Lightning Lester. I'm the fastest dude in my block. You want me to stand there?
Well, it's very easy to get a nasty cramp. And if you haven't worked out beforehand, forget about it. If you have pepper spray, use it. Use it to make that big old bear sneeze. Chew.
Rich, sneeze?
Sneezing makes a bear lose control of his bladder.
Come on, Rich.
Well, not fully. But a bear losing his bladder does get embarrassed, and an embarrassed bear does not want to be mocked and ridiculed. Avoid eye contact with a bear under any circumstance. If you see a bear approaching, you look down and to the left. And if you have something to say to a bear, you direct it to their assistant. I'd like to speak to a bear. The most important thing of all, Yasser, is do not expose yourself to a bear.
Well, don't expose yourself to anybody ever.
Beg to differ. Well, if a bear approaches, just lay down quietly, put your hands over your neck, then just go to sleep. He should get the picture.
Okay, the picture being...
That you are not interested in a relationship. It's time to move on, bear. Go to some other human.
Okay, well, thanks for sharing those bear facts with us, Rich. And right now we want to recap a few of them. Okay, so the first one being, don't run. You want to plant yourself where you are.
Ah, it's a bear! I'm looking at his eyes! Yes, sir, run! It's a son of a two bear! Run! Turn your back and run!
Okay, well, I guess that's all the time we had with Rich for today. And don't forget to see Disney's Bears in Regal Theaters this week.
Was that terrifying?
I mean, I was fine, but clearly Rich was horrified. Not as scared as I was that one time I saw Oculus, though.
That one time being this weekend?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I saw Rio 2, which was delightful, but yes. I want to hear about Oculus.
Okay, you like being scared?
Yeah, I mean, in general, yeah.
Okay, well, you're going to love Oculus. It was terrifying. It was produced by Jason Blum, Blumhouse Productions. Mm-hmm. They did, like, Paranormal Activity and Insidious.
All
and
the Purge movies.
All the Purge movies.
So scary.
Exactly. And they do this really cool live haunted house in downtown Los Angeles every Halloween. Like, they get super into it, you know?
They're the king of scares.
They're the king of scares. And the movie is actually two storylines running concurrently with one another, going back and forth. And then it all kind of comes together in the end in a spooky way.
You don't want to spoil it.
No, I can't.
You can't spoil
it. You have to see it.
Yeah.
You know? You have to see it. Oculus, the movie is about eyes.
Got it.
See, I just did a pun there. Here's a fun fact, though. Along with Blumhouse Productions, the other production company involved in the movie, World Wrestling Entertainment.
They're getting into horror films?
Yes. I mean, most of their movies before, they've done a few movies, and they usually star a wrestler, like there's one with John Cena, but this one is just a movie they did.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's pretty incredible.
Yeah.
I'm going to go see it.
You should.
I got to see it. You know what I saw this weekend that was not scary?
Huh?
Rio 2, starring Jesse Eisenberg and Anne Hathaway, who were in the first one. Plus, they added all these new characters played by new people, Kristen Chenoweth, Bruno Mars, et cetera.
Star-studded.
It's like a rhinestone suit.
Oh.
Absolutely.
Well, I love that.
This one takes place in the Amazon, so still in Brazil.
Okay.
And kind of follows this, like, kind of earthy storyline where there are loggers who are threatening the rainforest, a.k.a. just slashing trees everywhere.
Right.
And threatening the habitat of the birds. You know, it's about birds.
Yeah.
And it's weird because, like, I was watching these logging scenes, and I was like, why are they using real footage?
Yeah.
And then I thought, oh, no, this is how good the animation is. And that happened to me twice.
Yeah, so it's, like, almost scary.
It was scary how good the animation is.
Can I be honest with you?
Yeah.
Okay, I was listening about Rio 2.
Okay.
Let me start by saying that. Uh-huh. But then I started thinking about Oculus again and like what would happen if we mixed Oculus and Rio 2 into like a super movie.
Oh, like a mashup. I know where you're going.
Like a game. Like a game called Horror Cartoons. Ladies and gentlemen,
You like that? Yeah, I love it.
Okay. Well, here's how you play horror cartoons. You take your favorite horror movie, mix it with your favorite animated film, combine it, leave it in the comments below. Make sure you subscribe for your chance to win.
Okay, what is it? Bada bing, bada boom. These Rio 2 glasses by Real D, plus a whole prize pack by Real D, and a Rio 2 poster signed by Anne Hathaway, Jesse Eisenberg, George Lopez, Kristen Chenoweth.
Star.
Absolutely. You want to do it?
Are we going to play?
Yeah. I'm going to take these off. I feel like it gives me an upper hand.
Okay, but do you feel like I'm like in more 3D when you're wearing them?
Oh,
like, I'm
like,
come here.
You're intense.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay, again, here are my horror cartoons. Make sure you leave your own in the comments below. And make sure you subscribe. You got to subscribe to the channel in order to win. Here we go. First one, Rosemary's Bambi.
Ooh.
That's perfect.
That's really good.
Number two, How to Train Your Dracula. You thought I was going to say dragon.
And it still would have worked.
Said Dracula.
Yeah.
This one is perfect and brilliant on all levels. I just want to preface it with that.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, finally, Nightmare on Sesame Street.
Well done.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I feel like I won.
Okay. It's premature.
Is there a preemptive win?
No.
Okay.
No, I have to do
mine. I'll wait.
Yeah. Just do it. It's polite.
Okay.
These are my horror cartoon mashups by Aaron Gibson. Don't forget to leave yours in the comments below and subscribe. Let's begin. The Texas Chainsaw Madagascar.
Solid.
Pretty
That's
good.
Solid, yeah.
Psycho and Stitch.
No.
It's
That's actually kind of lazy.
Yeah. Shrexorcist. That one's good.
Best one by far. Like, by far
Thank
the best one.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Don't forget to put yours in the comments below. And don't forget to get your Regal Cinemas Super Ticket for Amazing Spider-Man 2. How many times do I have to say it? Exactly. You gotta get it.
Exactly. And subscribe to our channel.
Yes, and don't forget to YOLO.
Never forget to YOLO.
I'm YOLOing right now.
No on the YOLO.
This is how I YOLO.
Okay, well, that being said, I'm Yasser Lester.
I'm Erin Gibson. YOLO.
This is the trailer. YOLO.